below and the graticule. Introduction. Hi, I am Glory. What are you doing? Oh, are you studying the world map? Come, let us befriend the map. Make friends with maps. So tell me, what do you see in this map?
Good morning, student. In our 6th standard, we are going to learn our first lesson, the Earth and the Graticule. Here, on the digital board, you are seeing the world map, and the Ruby is going to explain some about the world map and something about the lesson in this short paragraph. Now, let's see it.
Right. We can see the continents in this map. In the same way, some cities, structure, and the people of some cities are also shown here. Now tell me, which different cities do you see in this map? Correct. Lima, Kimberley, Rome, St. Petersburg, Agra, Port Blair, and Tokyo are the cities seen in this map. Now tell me, which is the monument that is shown in this map? Very good. The monument shown in this map is the Taj Mahal. Has anyone of you seen the Taj Mahal? Okay. So now tell me, in which city is the Taj Mahal located? Correct. Taj Mahal is located in Agra city. Now tell me, Taj Mahal is located in which continent? Correct. Taj Mahal is located in the continent of Asia. Tell me, do you know about the various directions we use? Okay, so you know about them. Now, observe this map carefully and tell me, in which direction is Taj Mahal located? For Graham in St. Petersburg, for Kapia in Kimberley, for Michiko in Tokyo, and for Meenakshi in Port Blair. Correct. As for Graham of St. Petersburg, Taj Mahal is in the southeast direction, while according to Kapia in Kimberley, Taj Mahal lies in the northeast direction. For Michiko in Tokyo, the Taj Mahal lies to her west, while according to Meenakshi, Taj Mahal is located in the northwest direction. Now tell me, what would Shahid from Agra comment on the directions of the location of other persons shown in the map? Correct. He would say that Graham of St. Petersburg is in the northwest direction, Natalia from Rome is to his west, while Enrique's location in Lima is to his southwest. Similarly, Kapia from Kimberley is to his south, while Meenakshi's location in Port Blair is in the southeast direction, and Michiko's location in Tokyo is to his east. Now tell me, what would Natalia in Rome and Enrique in Lima say about the direction of each other's location? Would their answers be the same? No, their answers will not be the same. Natalia in Rome is located in the northeast direction of Enrique, while Enrique in Lima lies to the southwest of Natalia. You will is located at one and the same place, and that is Agra. But looking at the answers that Graham, Kavya, Michiko, Natalia, Meenakshi, Shahid, and Enrique gave using directions and subdirections, we realize that directions given by each of them from their respective locations are different. This means that identifying a location using directions alone need not be accurate. Thus, we can say that the direction of a particular place can be found using directions and subdirections, but there are limitations while identifying its accurate location. So far, we have learned how to identify the location of a particular place on the earth with the help of directions and subdirections. But taking into consideration the vast
Now, you see that the world map, you see in the world map there are 7 continents given here, there are some cities given here and some persons' names are given here. And some questions are given to us according to the map. The first question is which places are shown on the map. Here we see the different continent in the world. In which city is the Taj Mahal located? Where is the Taj Mahal located? Give you the answer. In which continent is the Taj Mahal located? In which direction is the Taj Mahal located? For Graham in St. Petersburg, for Katya in Cape Verde, for Michiko in Tokyo, and Meenakshi in Port Blair. Means, according to the directions and subdirections, there are some different answers given to these questions. For every person, the direction of the Taj Mahal is different. Shahid, in Agra is specifying the directions in which the other live. How will he express them? Then Shahid lives in Agra, specifying the direction, and others too. In which direction will Natalia in Rome and Enric in Lima say the other child lives? Will their answers be the same? For Natalia, who lives in Rome, and Enric, which lives in Lima, their directions are different, and after every person's directions are different for Taj Mahal. Graham, Katya, Michiko, Natalia, Meenakshi, Shahid and Enric have answered the above questions differently using directions and subdirections. Every person who is shown in this picture have different answers to the different questions. They answer their questions using the different directions and subdirections. The Taj Mahal is located at one end of the same place, and that is Agra. Taj Mahal is located at one end of the same place. However, when each of the children told the direction from their respective places, their answers were different. But when the persons answer the question using their different directions, their answers are different. This means that the use of directions alone does not help us to accurately describe the location of a place. Means, these directions does not help us alone to accurately describe the location of any place. That is why it became necessary to find a new system to state the practice location of any place on the earth. So, it is necessary to find new system to state the practice location of any place on the earth. Let us see what it is.
A method has been devised to accurately find the location of any place on the Earth's surface. Let me explain this method to you through a game. Should we start the game? Look at this chart. There are some rows and columns in it. Also, there are pictures of some animals and birds shown in these rows and columns. Now, study this chart carefully and answer my questions in terms of rows and columns. Now tell me, where is the picture of the elephant located in this chart? Correct. The picture of the elephant is located in the third row and fourth column in this chart. Now tell me, what is the location of the lion's picture in this chart? Very correct. The lion's picture is located in the fifth row and the first column. In the same way, we can find the location of any other picture in this chart with the help of the rows.
Students, here Ruby uses a chart. In this chart, there are some animals and there are some birds. And according to this chart, he explains us how to find out the location of a particular animal or of a particular bird. First, he gives us example of an elephant. And he asks us question, in which row the elephant's picture is and in which column? And the answer is the elephant's picture is in the third row and in the fourth column.
And columns. Thus, using this method, we can also accurately identify the location of any place on the Earth's surface.
Students, using this way, we also find the location of a particular place, location of any place on the Earth's surface.
Explanation. Look at this diagram. The length of the east, west and north, south diameters of the Earth is shown here. The length of the Earth's east, west diameter is 12,756 kilometers, and that of north, south diameter is 12,714 kilometers. The length of these diameters gives us an idea of the huge size of the Earth. Because of the oceanic water bodies, uneven nature of the land, forests, buildings, and the innumerable islands of various sizes, it is not possible to actually draw such horizontal and vertical lines on the Earth. In order to find a solution to this, geographers created a model of Earth in a miniature form, that is, a globe, and started using this globe to identify the location of the places on the Earth's surface. Remember, these lines drawn on the globe are imaginary lines and they are not actually present on the Earth's surface. How these lines are drawn on the globe? How the location of a place can be determined using these lines? Let us now learn about it. Angular distance. Remember, in order to determine the location of any place on the Earth, first, its position with respect to the center of the Earth is found out. For this, the line.
Now the explanation is given to us. Figure 1.2 shows the lengths of the east, west and north, south diameter of the Earth. In figure, before this, we saw, you saw the figure. In figure, the north, south and east, west direction, kilometer directions, lengths of the Earth is given to us. This will give you some idea about the size of the Earth. And by knowing this, the length of this Earth, you know, you get the idea about the size of the Earth, means how huge the size of the Earth is. Oceanic waters, uneven nature of the land, forest, innumerable islands of different sizes and building make it to actually draw such lines on the earth. But due to the oceanic water, uneven nature of land, forests, innumerable islands, then some buildings, and these all things makes draw such lines impossible actually on the earth. In order to overcome this difficulty, geographers develop a miniature model of the earth in the form of a globe. And to overcome this difficulty, some geographers develop miniature model of the earth. It is known as globe. This can be used to determine locations on the earth, and this globe is determined to find out the locations on the earth. One can actually draw horizontal and vertical lines on a globe, though not on the earth. Thus, they are imaginary lines on the earth. And we can draw some horizontal and vertical lines on the globe, which we are unable to draw actually on the earth. And these all lines are the imaginary lines. And in the next period, we are going to learn about how to draw, how to find out the actual location of any place by the angular distance, given angular distance of the earth, by using the angular distance of the earth.
Joining that place with the center of the earth is taken into consideration. This line forms an angle with the equatorial plane at the center of the earth, and this angular distance is used for determining the location of a place on the earth. Now, with the help of this diagram, let us understand how this angular distance is being used. Look at this diagram. Here, the angular distance of the place x from the equatorial plane is same as angle XMV, that is 30 degrees. Now, in the same way, tell me, what is the angular distance of the place Y? Correct. The angular distance of the place Y is angle YMV, that is 60 degrees. A plane that is parallel to the equatorial plane and passes through the point X is shown in the diagram. Observe how this plane meets the surface of the earth. It forms a circle on the surface. Any point on the earth's surface which is located on this circle forms an angle of 30 degrees with the center of the earth. Do it yourself. Let us draw a circle and assume it is the earth.
Students, you saw on the digital board how to find out the location of any place on the earth by using the angular distance, and I will explain this all you on in our next period. Thank you.